Legendary.
Welcome back. Our next segment. Yeah, that was great. Our next segment is Evan, our YBA reporter, is talking about the foundation for Metro West. Evan?
Thanks, guys. I'm Evan Berkowitz, and teens today are more able than ever to make their mark on the world around them. And the Foundation for Metro West has a way to help. Their youth and philanthropy program lets teens learn the ins and outs of the not-for-profit organization industry. Today, to learn more, I'm sitting down with Judith Salerno about the Foundation's youth and philanthropy program. Judith Salerno, thanks for joining me.
Thank you very much, Evan. I'm happy to be here.
Thank you. And let's get right to it. Could you explain a little bit about the Youth in Philanthropy program?
Sure. The Youth in Philanthropy program was started at the Foundation for Metro West about 14 years ago. And the goal is to engage local youth in the grant-making process, to teach them about the nonprofit sector through active engagement in the grant-making process. So local youth from area high schools come together and actually have the opportunity to read grant applications for youth-serving organizations in the Metro West. We teach the kids about how to read a grant, how to evaluate a grant. They actually have the opportunity to go on site and visit local nonprofits, and we teach them what a good grant maker does when they're doing a site visit. And then the kids then sit down with all of those grant applications and discuss and deliberate how they would actually like to distribute funds that the foundation provides them to these local organizations. So at the end of each program, each youth in philanthropy program, the kids actually distribute $10,000 to local organizations serving youth. So in many cases, they're peer groups or organizations.
Can you name some of them?
Sure.
In the past,
The kids have supported organizations like the Boys and Girls Club, Big Brother, Big Sister. There are hundreds of youth-serving organizations in the Metro West.
And how do you get involved?
So the community foundation, the Foundation for Metro West is a community foundation. So our mission is really to connect philanthropy with the need in the Metro West region. We define Metro West as 33 cities and towns. And what we do is we enable nonprofits and donors and grant makers to be connected to serve the region. So the kids, it's really an extension of the work that the foundation does as a grant maker. The foundation doesn't just serve youth organizations, it serves arts and cultural organizations, environmental organizations, and then also many human services, local agencies as well.
And for a teen involved in this program, what's the workload like on top of their normal schoolwork?
That's a great question. So the kids, the youth that participate in the program, they're typically high school sophomores, juniors, and seniors. And they meet twice a month from the beginning of the school year, usually October, through May. And so it's one evening that they commit twice a month to doing this. They then do, depending on the schedule, they typically will do some service together. They'll choose an organization together that they think would benefit from a group activity or service. Last year they did some cleanup work around the Lake Kitchewick watershed. And other times they've done the ropes course out at the Y out in Hopkinton. So there's a wide range of service work that they do as a group for both bonding as well as getting to know the organizations they're serving.
And why do you think that many teens choose to look into your program?
Well, I think there's a great emphasis in many of our organizations on having youth become more civically engaged and for providing more service. And I think that as a foundation, as a local community foundation, we think it's really important for youth to understand that there's opportunities to do work, to do service in their own backyard, and that you do not have to go very far to identify an organization or a need that would benefit from both your time and attention and most importantly, in terms of the grant making, some financial resources.
And it looks good on a college application too.
Well, that some people feel that way, and we think that's one of the benefits for it. But really, what we find is that many of the youth do it because they really do have an interest in doing local service.
And let's switch gears now and talk about the foundation itself,
okay.
Not just the program.
Okay.
Can you explain what exactly you do in our community?
Sure. So the foundation was formed 16 years ago by a group of local residents who felt that the philanthropic needs in the region were not being met and that there needed to be some concerted effort on building a resource to support our communities. So the Foundation for Metro West was created. We have about 50 funds that serve a wide range of organizations and needs in the region. We work with the nonprofit agencies to help strengthen them, help them build their capacity, and very importantly, help build their visibility in the good work that they're doing. When we think about the Metro West area, We think about it as a very family-oriented community. Many of us have chosen to live in Metro West and raise our families here, and that we have a lot of gratitude for many, many great acts of philanthropy that came before us, whether it's provisions for open space, great libraries, arts and cultural organizations, but that there's a responsibility that we all have for preserving the quality and character of our community for future generations. So
and
the foundation does that.
Yes. And how do you accomplish these goals? What type of projects or grants recently can you tell us about?
So as I mentioned earlier, we do grants in the family support category, and we're very focused and have a major initiative on the family support category because there are many families in Metro West who are in need of a little extra support right now. And so we are building our capacity to help fund more of the grant opportunities that exist. So the types of organizations we serve are everything from food support to at-risk youth programs. It just crosses the gamut. In terms of arts and cultural organizations, we have many wonderful organizations in the area, whether it's the DeCordova Museum or the Discovery Museum in Acton, the Danforth Museum. We have performing arts organizations. We had the opportunity to meet this morning with a very interesting Indian dance troupe called Chandika that is bringing their cultural heritage to the area in terms of dance performance. So there's a wide range of opportunities.
And you mentioned food support organizations. In these tough times,
yeah.
How do you get the donors to keep you guys running and able
sure.
to give grants?
So as a community foundation, our role is not just as a grant maker. We also have to build our resources to be able to provide that support. And that's why many people choose to work for a community with a community foundation, because we do know the needs that exist in the region. We feel very strongly that we have our pulse on the needs of the region and can identify great ways to connect donors to the opportunities that exist. So for example, I think the food support is a great example. Every year we distribute funds throughout the year to food support organizations, but particularly in terms of our end of year grant making program we do. When you think about many urban centers, they're able to meet their food support needs through one very large food bank or food support organization. Here in Metro West, we have over 45 food pantries that we're trying to provide some level of support. So finding them, supporting them, and keeping track on what their needs are is very challenging, and that's what our organization does for our donors.
And how do you find those donors? How do you get them to donate in times when money can be tight?
So that's the part of our marketing team. I mean, we have a fantastic board of directors who are leaders of the community who have committed themselves to supporting and building this organization because they think that Metro West is a community that needs and deserves a great community foundation. And through working with them, identifying their friends and family and businesses and colleagues, we do a tremendous amount of work with social media and opportunities like this to just do whatever we can to get the word out, not just about the needs and work of the foundation, but as the region as a whole. We want to be the storytellers, not just for the foundation, but for the region.
And about some of those donors, on your website, I noticed that it features three major donors, Ted English, who was the former CEO of TJX Corp right here in the area, Meg Ramsey, and Susan Carls Churchill. What are you guys at the foundation hoping to accomplish for yourselves and for them by posting their bios so prominently on your website?
So it always takes people who are willing to attach their name to something to build credibility and to grow the organization. We happen to have a number of people who have been extraordinarily generous in their time and willingness to lend their names. So having someone like the English family, Ted and Maureen English, are incredible local philanthropists who have a real desire to help people and really understand that they've been the beneficiaries of a lot of work that came before them and really want to give back. They had never had the opportunity to do a lot of local giving, and when they came to us, we were willing to work with them and develop an individual giving plan to help them identify organizations that met their personal philanthropic interests. And in their case, they were really interested in helping families in crisis and children with special needs challenges. And so we developed a giving program with them over the years to actually help them identify local organizations that met their philanthropic interests. And now we're working with the English children, who are now at an age where they're stepping in and learning about the kind of giving their parents have been doing. And we're working with them to show them not just how to be philanthropists, but help them to identify what their personal interests are in terms of philanthropy. And it's been a wonderful multi-generational opportunity and experience.
And quickly and in closing, how does one get involved with your organization? Give us some contacts.
They call us up. We're in Natick, Massachusetts, or they find us on the website, Foundation for Metro West, all spelled out, .org. And we are always looking. We do a lot of programming. We do a lot of convenings around issues in the community. And we really are happy to have lots of people engaged in our work. And there's 600,000 people, or over 600,000 people, that live in Metro West. We want them all to know about Metro West, and we want them all to know about the foundation and how they can join us in supporting this organization and community.
All right, then. Judith Solano, thank you very much
for
joining me.
Thank you very much, Evan.
I'm Evan Berkowitz, YBA News, Natick.
Thanks, Evan. That was a great interview, really informative, and I think everyone here enjoyed the interview. So I guess we've had a great show today, won't you say that?
Yeah, it was a great show.
It was a really great show.
It was awesome, especially having Devin here. It was just great.
Fun being back.
It is.
It's great to have you back.
It's great to have you back. So from me, Hannah, and Devin, and everyone behind the camera at the studio control room, this is YBA, Wicked Teen. See you next time.